Good morning. Today is my birthday. I turn 52 years old. That's amazing. I am so grateful that I've made it this far. And I'm looking forward to the future. So I made a big boo-boo. And that was forgetting that I have a big event tomorrow, which is Saturday the 25th. And I have friends coming into town, and I didn't realize that the event starts at 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. So that means I cannot be with you. So I am recording this on my birthday, which then inspired me to create a playlist of some of my favorite songs. They're workout songs, yes, but they're also just some of my favorites. And I put together a movement routine that includes a lot of my favorite exercises. So let's start off with one of my favorite poems this morning. So here we go. It's called Be a Light Sender by Karen Salmonson. Be someone who lets your inner light shine through, so you might shine and rise your highest self. Be someone whose light inspires others to shine more brightly, igniting their inner embers and brightening their inner darkness. Be someone who is a beacon for love, faith, and forgiveness, whose light sheds illumination on the steps to take, which lead to the highest good. Ask yourself each day what you can do to let your light shine more brightly. Be a light sender. I'm going to read it one more time. Be a light sender. Be someone who lets your inner light shine through, so you might shine and rise your highest self. Be someone whose light inspires others to shine more brightly, igniting their inner embers and brightening their inner darkness. Be someone who is a beacon for love, faith, and forgiveness, whose light sheds illumination on the steps to take, which lead to the highest good. Ask yourself each day what you can do to let your light shine more brightly. Be a light sender. Let's just take 3 breaths in and out together. And shining your light into yourself. And shining your light outwards as well. So this morning, as I was contemplating, realizing that I made a boo-boo, I thought, well, I'm just going to contemplate on some of the things that I've learned in my 52 years, and I'm going to share them with you. And I've learned a bajillion things, as we all have. But some of the highlights and the key points that arrived for me this morning as I was contemplating that are the things I want to continue to do and the things I want to continue to show up with and for. So I'd like to continue to be brave. Be kind. Stay true to myself and my character, even if people don't like me. Make the ask. So many times I haven't asked for what I want, and I am really working on shifting that to ask for what I want and what I need, and not just what I need, but what I want. And I figure, well, the only thing that they can say is no. And then I've turned no into the next opportunity, N-O, next opportunity. I'm still working on that. And I know that I'll be continuing to work on that for the rest of my life. I'd like to listen more. less talking, less sharing. And listen, I like to tell less. I like to remain open to the possibilities. So staying open to what's around me and open to what I don't see yet and know that there are possibilities in that. And I like to continue to look for the strengths in other people and let them know about them. Let them know what I see. And those are just a few of the things that I have contemplated this morning that I'd like to continue doing and or enhance in my life. Some of my challenges are letting go of perfection, letting go of being the expert, and just continuing to walk in the way that I want to walk on this earth and honor myself for all that I have done and all that I will do, and honoring myself and recognizing myself for that. So those are some of the things that I wanted to share with you this morning. Okay, so we're going to get into my workout because maybe it's a little bit longer than normal. That's okay. It's going to be fine. So we're only going to do two circuits today. Well, actually three. Two circuits. One's 8 minutes, one's 10 minutes. And then we have an arm burner at the end for Janice. No, only because I love arm burners. And that is about, I guess it's about 4 minutes. Okay. So I guess that's 18, 19, 20, 22. So 22 minutes of work, but we know that there's also this warm up. We have balance and we have technique. So we have that in the front of that. So I have incorporated my favorite moves into this workout. So we'll see how that goes. Let's set up our space. We do need a chair. We'll need our balls and we'll need our stretchy band. So grab all of those things, set your chair up because we'll use it in the workout and in the cool down. And we'll do some sit to stands combined with some different movements today. And as you're getting set up, I also created a playlist of some of my favorite songs. I have so many songs that are my favorites. And I was like, shoot, I don't know which one to pick. And then I thought, well, whatever. I'm just going to pick some of them. And we don't have enough time. Otherwise, we'd be here for like days listening to all of my songs. So I figured, well, there we go. And we'll have some fun listening to some of my favorite songs. And of course, Bumps is here. He's come in as I'm getting ready. As soon as I start moving, he was like, yeah, let's get going, guys. Come on. We got some workouts to do. Right, baby? Right, baby? Here comes his tail. Okay, I'm going to move the chair, baby, because I'm going to get up and get moving. So I'm taking my chair off. Oh, so for as far as weights today, you can bring in your light weights and bring in your medium weights so that you have all of your weights all around. Some of the movements are going to be new. We haven't done before. And I'm realizing in my socks, but who cares? I actually like to do a lot of my training in my bare feet or my socks. So just so that I'm really aware of my feet when I'm doing all that. So as we're setting up, and you're going to hear this beeping. Oh, I keep hearing beeping because I have my heart rate monitor on. And it's not picking up yet. Oh, well. So let's just start tossing Mr. Ball around. I'm going to turn on my music. Get the music going. Okay. So just tossing the ball, track it with your eyes. So you're looking up at it, looking at it when it catches into your hands. This is show me love. All right, now let it drop once. Catch it. Throw it up, drop it, catch it. We should be moving around. So feet are not planted. Feet are moving around your space. All right, let it drop twice. And then get it down as it goes lower and lower. You have to bend your knees. Bring an awareness to your back as you're doing that. So trying not to hunch over as you pick it up, but a flat back with a baby squat and maybe a hip hoop. Not a hip thrust, but a hip, what is these things called? I forget, the good mornings. So you're just hip hinge, I got it, still waking up. Now throw it up with one hand, let it bounce, catch it with the other hand. Woo! Oh, and I forgot, the birthday surprise is when you drop the ball, you do 5 jacks. So if you don't catch the ball and it goes off into the distance, go get it and then do 5 jumping jacks. Oh, shoot. Not for punishment, but for fun. Oops. All right, a couple more of these. Okay, hold your ball. You're going to toss it back and forth from one hand to the other as fast as you can, as fast as you can, as fast as you can. Yeah. You go faster. Oh, shit. Jumps. To do jumping jacks every time you drop it. 5 jumping jacks. And then go back to putting it back and forth. Now, don't just exchange the ball. You want to toss it. Toss it. Toss it. Toss it. Toss it. Yes. All right. 4 more. Oh, shit. I'm going to have to swear on my birthday. All right. Stop doing that. 5 squeezes. 5. 5 squeezes on the other. 4, 5. 5 quick squeezes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, ball between the knees. Squeeze in the knees, squeeze out the knees. Well, you're not going to be able to squeeze out. So it's just in, out, in, out. All right, we have a slight tilt back with the butt. Knees are coming forward over your toes. Yep. Now 8 squeezes fast. Go. Release. Put them off to the side. Grab your stretchy band. All right. Hands just at shoulder height. I'm starting at the bottom. A little bit loose in the middle. Yeah. All right. Knuckles down. Take a breath in. Lift your arms up over your head. And then exhale as you come down. Inhaling as you rise up. Exhaling as you go down. So you're not pulling the band apart. It's just controlled, right? It's not pulled. You're just controlling it. A couple more. Feel your shoulders moving up and down. Just shoulder mobility, right? Biceps by your ears. Yep, 1 more. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. Now inhale up. Let your rib cage go down. And exhale. 1 more. Inhale. Rib cage goes down. Exhale, release. All right, just shaking out the hands a little bit. I'm gonna do 1 more thing with the stretch band. Hands hip distance, or hip distance, shoulder distance, and then come up to shoulder height. Just pull the band apart. You've got 8 of these. I want you to pull your shoulder blades together. So the shoulder blades are going back and down. Here's a backside view. I don't know if you can see, but my shoulders are going back and down. I'm doing this slow and controlled. Got 3 more. Rib cage is down. And we're not flaring the lower back. 2 and 1. All right. Releasing. Shoulder cars, my favorite. Palms face you to start. So palms in, thumbs forward. Thumbs come up and around, up and over, till you can't go back anymore. I'm going to come down so you can see. Then I turn my hand all the way around, bring the arm all the way back behind me. And then now pinkies lead the way till I can't go anymore. I gotta turn my palm around. There we go. Now, rib cage awareness. Rib cages are back or down. And no flaring of the upper or lower back. Got 1 more. We're doing about 3 or 4 of these. I'm going the other direction. Or other direction, other arm. Thumbs back. Till you can't go back any further. Now, I just want to point out 1 more thing on this shoulder car. When you come to the top and you start going back, I want you to think about bringing your arm more midline. This is midline. So it's medial versus just letting the arm kind of splay out, right? Yeah, try that once more. Arms are midline. Try to keep the midline. You won't be able to, but you want to try to bring your arm inwards as you go back. Last time round. All right, feeling good. Okay, friends, here's the balance move before we get into technique today. So balance move, one of my faves. The airplane with a twist. So we'll try the airplane. I'll show you the airplane. Remember the airplane? We have one leg back, opposite arm is forward. We start with a T. Opposite arm comes in, and then we reverse and go the other way. Okay, so let's try a few of these. I'm just trying this hip rotation, and then the torso rotation as it goes opposite. And yes, you're gonna wobble. Look at me, I'm wobbling all over, who cares? I just know that as I'm doing this, my core is working, also my feet muscles and my ankle muscles are working. Last time, I gotta get off this leg. Stepping strategy. All right, let's try the other one. Here we go. So what I was doing was trying to go fast, right? Whenever I try to go fast, that's when it's all over. I'm gonna fall down. So just take your time. Hips are moving in space. Torso is moving in space. So is your leg, right? All this proprioception, proprioception, it depends on how you say that word and where you grew up. Where you heard it first. And release. Okay, we're gonna do that again. This time you're gonna close your right eye when you stand on your right leg. Okay, you ready? Standing on my right leg, I'm closing my right eye. And off I go. So I've got one eye of vision, but not the other. So I've got to move a lot more slow, and I'm going to have to adjust as I hop around on my leg. Remember, you could do this all by keeping the back foot on the floor. You're stretching it back, but you'll have those two points of contact. All right, one more time revolution. I'm starting to get sweaty. Like a pirate with one eye closed. No, we're on standing on the left leg with the left eye closed. Here's Madonna's song, by the way, Ray of Light, which is one of my favorites. I'm breathing somewhat hard as I just am focusing on doing this airplane with one eye closed. I'm gonna put my back foot down. I'm just talking as I go because maybe I'm connecting with something you're doing too, right? Last time for my rotation here. I feel. Last one round. And release. Oh my gosh, those are hard. Plus my eyes, yeah. So just let your eyes set, shake your body off. The technique move of the day is going to be the hip thrust. All right, so here we go. Hips, feet are wider than your hips. We know the hip hinge, right? We just tip over, we look ahead 6 feet, right? Hip hinge, stand up. So today we're going to stand up and thrust our hips forward, okay? So we tip, thrust. You have to use your glutes to do that. So we just thrust the hips forward. The hips aren't, we're not arching our back, but we are thrusting and thrusting. So I'm gonna come closer, you can see. Hips back, thrust. So my pelvic bone here leads the way, thrust. And I squeeze my both butt cheeks together. So try a few of those. Now, adding your arms, you're going to bring arms into the middle and then bring them up as you thrust. Bring, thrust. So we're flat back, we thrust forward. Flat back, thrust forward. Flat back meaning not arching as you go down, right? Okay, so we got down, we got up. Down, up. So try this. Down, up, down, up. So now you've got one arm going in, one arm going back, thrust. Down, thrust, down, thrust. Now just keep going. Down, rest. Down, rest. This will come really important when we add a weight, because the move, new move of the day today, is we have one weight between our knees. We bend, we come center, we catch, and we change grip. Change hands for the grip. So you're thrusting and pulling and exchanging the weight in between hands. Okay? I'm looking forward to doing that one in the workout with you today. This is the popcorn song, one of my faves. All right, are you ready to go? Hip thrusts, right? We're gonna work on that today. We've got two circuits. First one's 8 minutes long, three moves. We are doing about a medium weight on this, maybe a lighter weight to exchange. The first move, the first segments are gonna be with only one weight. So the first combo, first circuit, only one weight. So you want about a medium to light to heavier weight. So I'm setting up, my first move is the plank pull through. So we can do these on our knees or on our toes. We set the weight by the hip. So it's not in front, it's at the hip. Setting up, you can stay on your knees, you pull the weight through one side to the other side. That's the first move. Second move. I can't even remember my moves today. Is a one arm. Oh yeah. So one arm bicep curl. We have a bicep curl. We stop at the shoulder. Then we baby squat, push overhead. Back to the shoulder, elbow in, come all the way down to the bicep. Bicep hammer curl, set, push overhead, catch, bicep curl down. So it's bicep, push overhead. Do you see how I'm using my legs to push overhead? I'm actually using my legs to bicep curl too, pushing overhead. Side angle, I want to show you this one. So it is a bicep curl, baby squat, push overhead, baby squat. So we're using our whole body to push the weight around. So it's a bicep curl, overhead squat. They are heavier weight, right? Okay. Then we have the bell toss. So all it is you start in the middle. Belly is strong. I am not hunched over. I am flat. I'm in the middle, through the legs, through the crotch. You're up at the crotch, right? Then you come shoulder height. You're going to exchange the weight as the other leg arm comes through the middle. So you're catching in the middle. Just don't do this in front of a mirror, just in case the weight goes ahead. So try a few with me. Up, catch, exchange, catch, exchange. You're bending your knees. This weight is like right as the arm goes back, it just kind of stops right in the middle. The weight doesn't go very far back. So you're bending the hips, bending the torso, hips go back. Catch, hip thrust, hip thrust, hip thrust. All right, that's a lot, isn't it? So plank pull throughs, bicep curl, elbow in, push overhead, elbow in, come down. Then we move into the bell toss catch. So for the first round, plank pull throughs alternating, right? And then right arm only overhead. Second round, we'll add the other arm. So it's just one arm, other arm. We'll do each movement for 8 repetitions. So 8, 8, 8 for 8 minutes. Okay? All right. I know that was a lot. Next round's going to be easier to remember. But we've got 8 minutes, 8 repetitions, 3 moves. Getting ready. I am starting the timer. And we have 8 minutes on the clock. Let's go. Plank pull throughs. Sit on your knees, weight by your hips, pulling through. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 7, 8. My microphone is getting in the way. Then I take my time to stand up, pick up my weight. One bicep curl, overhead. And 1, 2, 3. Remember, when you push up overhead, bicep towards your head, use your legs a little bit, deep squat. 5, 6.
Awesome.
7. Last one. 8. Whew. All right, now we're trying these hip thrusts with the catch in the middle. You're going to start in the middle, come at your shoulder height, exchange the weight. 3, 4, 5, 5, hip thrust, 6, squeeze your butt, 6, good, 7, 7, 8, 8, and we start all over again, setting up the plank pull through. I'm going to try some on my toes. I'm set the weight by my hips, by my knees to set up. Maybe I come on my toes, maybe I don't. And I'm pulling the weight underneath me, across and underneath me. So you're only pulling one weight, right? So if you've got a 3-pound weight, you're really not doing anything. You may as well just, you know, go eat some bonbons. Last one for me. And then I take my time to stand up, doing the left hand 8 times. So we've got the bicep, push overhead. Use your legs, remember, little baby squat, push overhead, baby squat. So it's a baby squat, baby squat. So every time you come up to the finish of the move, that's where your squat is. Almost like you're doing a hip thrust here too, right? Yes. And then into the between the legs, exchange the weight. 1, 2, 2. Use your hips. 3, 3. Use your glutes. 4, 4, 5, 5. Stop at shoulder height. 6, 6. It's actually nose height by the time you're done. 7, 8, 8. Woo. All right. Starting again. Plank pull through. As you were doing this, I need a drink. I got a drink. So plank pull throughs are pretty challenging. I want you to bring awareness to your hips. Try not to let the hips rotate or the shoulders rotate. You're on 3 points of contact. You want to push into the mat with the hand that's on the floor. Yeah, so that's how you stay straight without rotation. This is anti-rotation movement. So we're stopping our body from rotating. One more way through. Then I stand up with my weight or do the walk-throughs, right? Here we come again. We're already halfway through. 4 minutes just clicked. So I lift my heels, I squat, push to the top, and squat. So you can see my heels, they come up, and they come up. Just using my whole body for metabolic conditioning. Check your elbow, it stays pretty close to your body. 2 left to make 8. Ooh. Coming into the tosses, weight tosses. So start in the middle, bend the knees, hip thrust. Yes. Use your hips, use your whole body. Finish off. I like to finish off on this. You can keep going, but I like to finish off with letting it go through, come through, and then put it on the mat. And then start again, right? Playing pull throughs. Set up the weight, my hips. Hips come forward. They're not up in the air. They're forward. So tuck your tail under and start pulling it through. So we're always setting up the foundation before we get going, being clear of where our bodies are in space. And also, why did we put our hand there? Why do we put our knees there? Why are our hips there? So that we're very clear and purposeful. Doing fine. I'm switching arms for my bicep curl. Push overhead. Side angle. You can see that. There it is. Elbows close. Push overhead. Bicep is close to my ear. Elbows close. Down. So I'm controlling every single motion, and so are you. Ooh, this is getting challenging here. There's a lot of repetitions here, right? So we just take our time. There is no rush. One of my ultimate favorites just came on. Everybody, dance now. Here I come, starting in the middle and exchanging. My chin in a little bit. So I was trying to jut my chin out. Pull it in. Start using my arse. We are working our arses off here. Working our arses on here. What do you want to do? Make some butt or get rid of some butt? Yeah, we want to all get rid of the butt, actually. It's and. And I want to work my, and I want to. Oh. All right, we got 30 seconds left already. Woo. I notice my breath is faster, but it's not, it's manageable. I'm really paying attention to my hips and my shoulders when I'm in this plank through. Got 10 seconds left already. Woo-hoo. Hands in the air, come on, say yeah. Everybody over here, everybody over there. The crowd is loud. Activity completed. Whew. All right. Man, just rest for a minute. We got about a minute rest, a little bit more than over a minute, because I'm going to show you the next routine, all with two weights. If you want two weights, you can always put one weight down and do it with one weight. All is good. All is great. We just keep on moving. So this is 10 minutes circuit, continuous work. You're going to continue on with not eight repetitions, but you're going to continue on through the whole thing at steady work. And we'll do about a 45 seconds of work on each exercise. There are only four exercises. However, we're combining some of them together. So first move is a sit to stand with a row. So I'm gonna get two weights. I've got two of my medium size weights, getting my chair set up, getting me set up. So I'm going to sit to stand in a suitcase carry. So the weights are close to my body. I sit to stand, then I tip, do a row, stand up and sit down. Except we're doing three of each thing. So I'm gonna do three sit to stands. Two, three, I stay standing on the third. I tip and I pull and I row three times. Then I stand, then I sit. One, two, three, tip, row, three, two, one. All right, yes, so that's the first move. Then from there, I'm taking my weights, either one or two, curl them up, put them together, push up over my head, rib cage is down, triceps extension. We're just gonna keep going. So we need to take a break and then we pause and then we start again. because we're working that particular move for 45 seconds. Yes. Then we put the weights down off to the side and out of the way. One of my favorites, little hop turns. So we've got 30 seconds of hop turns, bending your knees, bending your knees, bending your knees. You could stagger your landing. Ba-ba, ba-ba, ba-ba. Or you can jump turn them too. 45 seconds. And then the final move, prone to get up to stand. So I'm prone. I turn on at my side and or not. I'm going to show you what the choice is. Walk my feet to my hand. Stand up. Come all the way back down. So you'll have 45 seconds of getting up and getting down. There's another choice if you would like to try a burpee. This is up to you. So we start in supine. We push ourselves up. You could just walk your feet forward and stand up. Hands come back down. Walk your feet back. Come all the way to the floor. So you're pushing up. You could stagger your feet to stand, or you could walk your feet in like we've been practicing. Did you know that those getting up off the floors, I was conditioning you to get to a burpee? You didn't know? It's all good, because guess what? That's what a burpee is, just getting up off the darn floor, okay? So you can do that. You choose what you want to do, but you've got 45 seconds to just do them all. Four movements, sit to stand combined with a row, three repetitions each. Second one, overhead, triceps extensions. 45 seconds, you're going to take a break anytime you need one in that combination, in that triceps extension. You're going to take a break anytime you need it anyways. Then the 360 hops. 360 hops, meaning you could go all the way around in a circle, but I do want you to go both directions so you don't get dizzy. Okay. And then we will go prone and then get up any way we can get up, whether it's burpee, whether it's walking our feet in, we're just getting up and getting down. 45 seconds long. Timer is coming. Getting ready, getting set. First move, two weights, grab them up. And here we go. So we're just doing three stands and a suitcase carry. Suitcase is just the hands by the side. That's how we'd carry a suitcase, right? If we had to, now we have wheels. Then we tip and we row. Elbows come in and weights go to the hips. Then you stand up and you go again. So 45 seconds here. We've already done 20. So I keep my weights very close to my body. So you keep the load close, right? In all things. We've got 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left, break. Setting up for the next move is a triceps extension. You could use one or two weights. I'm gonna start with two, knowing that I could put the weights down. So, okay, let's try it. Thrusting, elbows come up, just like what we just did in the last one. Weights come together. Watch your nose as you go overhead. Rib cage down, soft knees, and off we go. Weights come towards the head, back of the neck, or top of the shoulders. Then they go straight up overhead. How's your rib cage? Bring it down. Tuck your tail under a little bit. Ground your feet into the mat. Whew. We've got 15 seconds here. Remember, you could do one at a time, right? Oh, I just hit myself in the head. These are heavy. Ugh. 5 seconds left. 2, 1. Watch your nose on the way down. Weights go off to the side. Get them out of the way. Oh man, this is Tom Petty coming up here. We won't back down, right? We've got our 360 hops coming up. Here they come. Here we go. So I'm just hopping. Hopping, hopping. I'm going to go all the way around in a circle. So I'm just getting my knees mobilized here and getting used to moving in a circle. And then I might try a little bit more range of motion, like maybe a jump with both feet landing. You're going to be the judge of you in how you do that. But land soft, land soft. Let the absorption go into all of your muscles too. I'm bending my knees, bending my knees. I'm landing soft, soft. We've got 5 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1, break. Stand my ground, and I won't back down. I'm gonna move my chair because I want to get more room. I'm going to the floor, starting off on my belly, prone, getting ready to pit up. Here we go. Let's go. So I might start off with just coming to all fours. Weight comes on my hands as I walk my feet towards my hands. And then I come all the way back down, back to my belly. Woo-hoo. Maybe I might want to try a little jump. Maybe I don't. So I push myself up, walk my feet a little faster to get up. Yeah, why not? And you go a little faster with walking those feet up. Three, two, one. Ooh, we're starting all over again. All right, so we've got the sit to stands. The good news is we're already at 4 minutes, right? Sit to stands coming at you. Three sit to stands, three rows. Go. Stand up three times. Stand up quick, right? Yes. And I tip flat back, elbows back, hands to my rib or to the hips as I pull the weights up and back and down for the rows. Here they come again. Tip flat back, push the tailbone back, pull, pull, pull. Weights are close to my body. They're not way in front. They're close. Two, three. So when I do a row, the weights are close to my legs. You see how they're close? Then I pull close, pull close, pull. Three, two, break. Get ready, triceps extension. I'm gonna go with one weight this time because I found that was heavy and I got out of control. I don't like being out of control. I like being in control. So you choose one or two weights. Off we go. First check, rib cage. Rib cage, no arching. Tuck your butt under, rib cage down. Control of your torso so you are stacked. Pull your belly button in. Yes. This is one of my super duper fave songs. We've got 15 seconds left here. Elbows go out to the sides, then a full extension. Yes, and to make it even more challenging, pull your elbows in a little bit closer to your head. You will really target your back here. Arm. Three, two, one. I really want to put this weight down. So give your arms a shake. We've got our hops coming at you next. Woo-hoo. 5 seconds left. Anytime you need a drink, get it. Ready, set, and go. Little hops, 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 hops. So when I land, my toes go toe heel. When I push off, it's a heel to toe. So I'm heel. So I'm using my whole foot. I'm not just staying on my tippy toes the whole time, right? I'm letting the heels come down at some point. That helps use your full stretch reflex, which is a plyometric technique. It's push off the foot, roll through the whole foot, reload, push. You are doing that. Awesome work. We are doing it. Woo-hoo. Roll through the whole foot, heel to toe, heel to toe, heel to toe. Soft knees. Three, two, one. I only did half of it, so I can imagine how you're feeling, but you did that. You did that. We've got 5 seconds left. Coming down to belly. Coming down to belly. How are you going to do these this time? If you'd like to try something fun, you could, instead of coming onto your knees, you could push yourself up to full plank, then walk your hands, feet in to your hands. That's pretty challenging. If you'd like to try the full burpee, all you're just going to do is push up, jump both feet in, stand up, hands come back down, you jump your feet back, come all the way down. Hey, we've got 10 seconds left. And done. 2 minutes of work left. This round, 30 seconds of work each. Get ready for your sit to stands. Don't worry. Be happy. Get ready. Here we go. Sit to stands. Three stands. Two, one. Stay up. Three rows. Whew. Keep the weights close. Be happy. 15 seconds left here. Three rows. Two and one. Let's go right into the next move. I'm going to put one weight down, triceps extension, rib cage down, arms straight, then arms bend, push up. So the weight comes to the back of my neck, kind of the upper back, actually, by the time the ball of the head of the weight gets down there. Elbows are close and we're breathing. Rib cage down, yes, 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 yes. Three, two, one. Go right into your hop turns. Put my weights out of the way and then off I go. Okay, be happy. We've only got 1 minute left. If you can sing now, it would be good. Ooh, 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 ooh. See, I'm changing direction, right? Change direction. Don't just go in one direction. Ooh, 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 ooh. Ooh. Okay, last move. Getting up and getting down. Okay, getting up and getting down. Ain't got to make you smile. Don't worry. Everything is okay. Everything you're doing is purposeful for your life. You have to get up and down off the floor, right? We've got 5 seconds left.
Activity complete. Oh,
that was a quick 5 seconds. Woo, walk it off. All right, friends. How are you feeling? What is your rate of perceived exertion? I'm putting my heavier weights, my medium-sized weights off to the side. I'm not going to use them on this next one. I'm going to grab my light weights, my light ones. And I'm going to grab a drink too, because we got our arm burner coming next, which is only 4 minutes long. Arm burner has a few different moves. Yes. So we are going to do, how did I decide to do? Oh yeah. Okay. So combination of two or four moves. We do two moves for 30 seconds. Then we go right into the next move. So all this one is feet hip distance, solid. Ground yourself down, rib cage down right away. You do a front raise, lateral raise. Front raise, elbows lead the way, lateral raise. Front raise, lateral raise. That's the first 30 seconds. Second 30 seconds, bicep curl, push overhead. Bicep curl, pull down. Bicep hammer curl, elbows are close, push overhead, rib cage down, all the way through. 30 seconds. All right, and then we alternate between the two. And then the final move, I'll tell you when we get there. Get ready. Here comes 4 minutes of work coming at you. Get set, front raise, lateral raise. Try it. Ground down, front, core strong, side. You could do one arm at a time because we're only doing 30 seconds of each, but these are challenging. I won't say they're not. Or both arms together. Yeah, 7 seconds left. We're gonna go right into the bicep curl, press overhead. Get ready, go. Bicep curl, push overhead. Right away, by a rib cage down. You could do this one at a time for 30 seconds and then switch arms, right? Yes. Okay, you got 11 seconds here. Rib cage down. I'm tucking it in. I'm tucking my butt cheeks under. I'm lifting my heart up at the same time. Break. Just take a break. Put the weights down. Give your hands a shake. We're doing that all again in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Front raise. Side raise. Soften your knees. Yes, you're grounded down. Grounded down to the earth. 5 seconds here. Man, these are hard, aren't they? Lead with your elbow on the side raise. Elbow goes first, then the rest of the weight. Yes, done. Bicep curl, push overhead. All right, friends. We're almost through here. We've got 2 minutes left. We've already almost done 2 minutes. And the arms are like, girl, what are you doing? 5, 4, get ready to put the weights down quick. 2, and 1. Weights go down. Keep them close. Give your hands a shake. We're doing our grip strength here too, right? Get ready. 5, pick up your weights. 4, 3, 2. Front raise. Go. Front. Side. Front. Lead with your elbow. Elbow. So my weight is a little bit lower. My weight is not higher. My weight is lower than my elbow. Yep. Oops. Oh man, I got stuck in my wires. Birthday workouts are fun. 3, 2, 1. Bicep curl. Go overhead. Bicep curl. So I'm close. My elbows are close. I push up my body. Yes. So these weights should be lighter than what you've used all day, I hope. And if you kept the same weight, good for you. Good. I'm glad you kept the same weight. However, next time you do this workout, maybe you do it in a couple days, you might try heavier weights. You always put them down and then pick up the other ones. All right, get ready. 3, 2, 1. Break. We're doing this one more time. All right, this is our last minute of work here. Last minute. Get ready. Pick them back up. 5, 4, 3, 2. Lateral raise. Solid foundation. Or front raise. It doesn't matter which one you do first. Don't matter, right? Don't matter. Remember, we're looking at the possibilities. We don't always have to be right. That's me. I'm talking to myself. You don't always have to be right. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bicep curl. Go overhead. Yes. Rib cage. Rib cage. What's it doing? Knees soft, right? Yes, Nicole. You've got 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Arm burner. Yes, ma'am. Put your weights down. Let's give our hands a shake. Get the blood flowing back in there. Let the arms go down. Now shake the whole arm. Whole arm. Whole arm shaking. Shaking, shaking, shaking. Then roll the shoulders back. Back and down and around. Amazing effort. Roll the shoulders forward a little bit, the blood back into the shoulders. And then give me some rotations. Breathing easy. Yeah, right. I'm breathing hard, but it feels good. So that workout, according to the minutes of actual effort with the weights, we did an 8-minute set, we did a 10-minute set, and then we added 4 minutes on. So that's a significant amount of weight training here. Let's pull one arm across the chest. Let this shoulder go down away from your ear. If it's up here, let it go down. Mm-hmm. Rotate the wrist, relax your shoulders, and breathe. I keep my feet moving for some reason. I think it's just my body saying, don't slow down yet, just keep going. And then release this arm, let it swing, swing, swing. Maybe your feet move as you swing, swinging the arm. Breathe in, breathe out. Oh, hold on, I'm saying buy my hubs. Thanks for my birthday present. All right, now the other arm goes across. Check the shoulder, let it go down away from the ears. I'm going to get on my favorite, some of my favorite slower songs. Rotate your wrist. Make sure you go both ways with that rotation, right? Yeah. Okay. Let me see. I don't want to put that one on yet. Here we go. And then open your arms big. Fingers are straight. Yeah. Now take your fingers and tilt them back. Yes. Take a breath in. Let your rib cage move a little bit. Yeah. Good. So my hands are back. Take a breath in. Lift your arms up. Now exhale, bring your arms back and down. So we're going down all the way down. Easy, 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 easy. Now release the hands and then just go back up. Flex the wrists, breathe in, go up. Exhale, flex the hands, go back. Lift your heart all the way down. We're stretching the shoulders, the wrists, the forearms at the same time. Now stand on your hands. Let your shoulders go down. Good. And release. Grabbing the chair, I'm turning it around just to use it for my back stretch. One or two hands on the chair, feet are back. Take a breath in, lift your heart. As you exhale, push your tailbone back. Chest comes through between the hands and the arms. And maybe it goes down, but you don't want to force. You're not forcing anything. Now, as you're here, just wag your tail. Easy, easy. Breathe in and out. Take a moment, arch the back. Now let the back go the other way like a cow. Cow, if you do yoga. And now cat stretch, cat stretch. Now come to neutral. Look at your feet. Walk them in towards your hands. Come all the way back up. Hands to thighs. Let's arch the back here and then come down. So tailbone comes in. Tailbone goes way back like suction cups on the back wall. One more. And exhale. Come to seated. I'm going to cross once I get to seated on towards the edge. I'm going to cross one leg over the other. I have to just adjust so your tailbones are down. Take your posture, lift it up, take a breath, and exhale. If this is not comfortable for you at all, just cross your ankle at ankle at the ankle. And wherever you are, take a breath in with both arms. And then clasp hands, and then just tip easy, small, side to side. There we go. And release. Let's try the other side. Adjust, square the hips, settle your body, breath in, breath out. And then breath into both hands, maybe clasp them at the top, and then just tip. So we're just moving the rib cage laterally. Boop, boop. This baby. My little. You want to come up? He does. He gets the mode of shaky tail, we call it, where he purrs. His whole body is purring so much that his tail, the super long tail, starts to vibrate like this. We call him shaky tail. Come on, come on. So the last stretch, or actually the last thing we're going to do is sit together for just a moment in silence.
Activity completed.
Oh, yes. Thank you, computer. Activity is completed. Thank you for being here. Thank you for honoring your beautiful, strong body, your wise soul, your brilliant mind. stay a few moments longer. Be someone who lets your inner light shine through, so you might shine and rise your highest self. Be someone whose light inspires others to shine more brightly, lighting their inner embers and brightening their inner darkness. Be someone who is a beacon for love, faith, and forgiveness, whose light sheds illumination on the steps to take, which lead to the highest good. Ask yourself each day what you can do to let your light shine more brightly. Be a light sender. Coming back to your space. Looking around, noticing what's around you. What's familiar? Notice what's in your body at this moment. Thank you from all of my heart. Bumpy thanks you too. I hope you have an incredible day. And if it's not an incredible day, just have a day. We can all have one of those too. And thank you so much for your patience with me every single time. Am I showing me so much grace and understanding? You are amazing, and I'm grateful for you. I'm grateful for our time together.